Hello, my name is Quentin Roulant from the IRIT Laboratory at the University of Toulouse. My talk today is about the work I did in collaboration with my colleague Barry Mamid, also from the IRIT Laboratory, and Jason Jaskolka from the Carleton University of Ottawa. The topic is about reusable formal model for cell specification, detection, and treatment. Here an outline of the talk. I will first present the motivation. Then I will present an overview of the proposed approach. After that, I will present our proposed modeling framework and reusable security thread and requirements libraries. And finally, I will present an outline of the prototype tool we developed to support our approach. Let's start with the motivation. In the recent years, there are a shift from traditional computer system toward the Internet of Things, cloud-based application, wireless communication, and other interfaces. It means the systems become more and more heavily distributed. Consequently, a reconfiguration of secure and trusted system engineering process must be done. Because such a distributed system, due of its nature relying on a lot of communication channels, face a lot of potential threat against them. It means the increase of potential threat against the system at communication level, but also for each of the components themselves, with the increase of interfaces exposed. It translates in terms of threat of a lot of more threat to consider against the system. So it's become more and more important to be able to detect and treat such threats easily. If we summarize, secure system engineering is becoming increasingly complex, costly, and critical, with the distributed nature of nowadays system. So we seek to respond at some part of these problems with our approach by proposing an approach based on three key points. The use of threat analysis to detect threat at early stage of system development processes. The use of reusable library formally verified. And finally, the use of an automated tool as support of the approach to ease the verification. Let's continue with an overview of our proposed approach. So the goal of the proposed approach are to formalize the security requirement of the system, determined through threat modeling as desired property of the system architecture, verify the desired properties, and suggest new security requirements to improve the system design and treat any identified security violation. So the proposed approach is composed of two blocks. On the left, the first, the modeling framework process for reuse, which is the process to define new reusable libraries. And on the right, the application framework process for reuse, which is a process to model a secure software architecture. We look now at the first block, the modeling framework process for reuse. In this block, we consider both the conceptual modeling and formalization. So let's take a look first at the conceptual modeling. We begin by modeling a component port connector meta model as high-level concept of the software architecture. We provide a structure and behavior concepts to ensure the software architecture are well formed and support asynchronous message passing communication. In addition, we develop a property view of the meta model to describe security threats and requirements. Then, in the second part, the formalization, after constructing the component port meta model, we formally specify the developed model using a suitable tool with automated tool support for model check-in and verification. We obtain this way a formal architecture meta model and a formal specification of some representative security threats. This gives us a set of reusable threat libraries capable of identifying security threats in a concrete software architecture model. We finally develop a specification of security solution to mitigate this threat. The result is a set of abstract formal security solution module that can be easily reused. Going through the second block, the application framework process for reuse, we build a concrete architecture by instancing the abstract architecture metamodel into a concrete model for an application-specific distributed software system. Then, using the application-specific security requirements, we use the security threat libraries to identify potential threats in the system model by checking that it satisfies the desired properties reflecting the security requirements. If we determine that the system model does not satisfy the security requirements, we use our developlet libraries to incorporate security solutions to treat those threats in the software architecture model. We then verify the satisfaction of the security requirements in the updated software architecture model. As a final result, we converge to a complete set of security requirements that ensure that the software architecture model is secure. We now present our modeling framework to support our approach. We want to be able to represent scenarios like presented in this slide. So here a consumer requests some data and a gateway returns the corresponding data. So we choose to represent the structural parts as a component core connector architecture. And we choose to represent the communication as asynchronous message passing. To model such a system, we propose to build a modeling framework to define architectural models that are conceptually close to the industrial practice, meaning an UML-like vocabulary. The metamodel that we propose provides concepts for describing software architecture in terms of different views. First, the logical view, to capture the functional architecture of the system in terms of components, ports, and connectors. And secondly, the scenario view, which build open the logical view, describes the behavior aspects of the architecture elements in the respect of the target computing model. So here, asynchronous message passing. Finally, we define a third view, called the property view, used to describe threads and requirements in the form categories. It's allowed to build property model libraries that can be easily reused. These libraries are then used as external models to type the property of the component and connectors. In addition, we define mitigates as a link between properties to capture a relationship between requirements and threads. We will now see in the next few slides how we formalize threads and requirements in reusable libraries. In the context of our work, thread and security requirements are defined as properties and provided as a formal model libraries to support reuse. Here, in this slide, we present a representative thread sender spoofing as a security thread for the spoofing category from Microsoft Stride's classification. So the definition of the thread is given following our context of component port connector and asynchronous message passing communication. Then we formalize it with an high-level logical specification that can be easily understandable. Finally, we dive this logical specification into the reusable formal model. Here, the resulting reusable standard spoofing thread is expressed in Alloy. This thread is expressed as a connector property and then that will be easily instantiated in the concrete architecture. Then we use the same approach to define a requirement in the same way that will treat this thread. So here the spoof is defined as a representative security requirement to treat the sender spoofing thread. Of course, we formally verify that the treatment is effective using a verification with the automated tool. So here, through an assertion in Alloy. I will now show the prototype we developed to support this approach. The architecture of the tool is composed of two main blocks, the modeling framework blocks and the application development block. Each block is composed of a set of modules to support the corresponding activities. So, let's take a look at the first block that supports four activities. The first activity, 1.1, is responsible for creating the domain-specific language metamodel. The resulting metamodel is used to formally define in alloy the static and behavior semantics, we name this definition the formal metamodel as activity 1.2. Them, reusable thread model library and security requirement model libraries are also defined as alloys models according to activity 1.3. The last activity 1.4 is the definition of set of domain-specific language model libraries from the alloy specification of thread and requirements using the property view of the domain-specific language metamodel. Each thread property is as low associated with a set of security requirements to mitigate it. The second block is dedicated to support 8 activities. First, the activity 2.1 allows the designer to model a software architecture conforming to the domain-specific language metamodel. Then, the activity 2.2 allows to integrate the thread specification reusing the already developed thread model libraries. Then, activity 2.3 is the generation of the formal model in alloy from a domain-specific language model through a transformation engine. The formal tool, here the analyzer, is then invoked with several iterations to detect the targeted thread in activity 2.4. Then, in activity 2.5, a report on the detected thread may be generated as an HTML document. The report is then analyzed during activity 2.6, and the activity 2.7 allows the designer to add the corresponding security requirement to the domain-specific model, raising the domain-specific model libraries and the mitigated relationship between properties presented in the first block. The resulting domain-specific language model is then transformed to a formal alloy model in activity 2.3, where the formal definition of the corresponding security requirement are automatically added in the produced alloy software architecture model from their domain-specific language definitions. At the end of mitigation, meaning that the tool for the verification don't find any more any violation, a security requirement report is generated as an HTML document in activity 2.8. To support this 8 activity in the second block, we developed a textual editor to model the architecture of the system using the Eclipse modeling framework and Xtext. In addition, the textual editor provides autocompletion for the manual integration of the thread library, proposing the possible thread categories and properties for software architecture elements when the designer is typing the elements. We also developed two transformation engines to generate the formal alloy model and one for the HTML reports using Xtend. Finally, the analyzer is used to verify the resulting model and generate counterexamples that show the violation of security requirement. To conclude, in our work we propose an approach to thread specification detection and treatment in component-based software architecture models via reusable security thread and requirement formal model libraries. Our solution is based on metamodelic techniques that enable the specification of software architecture structure and on formal techniques for the purpose of precise specification and verification of security aspects as property of a modeled system. Furthermore, we develop a tool prototype to support the proposed approach. An example of this tool suite is constructed using Eclipse Modeling Framework Tool, Xtext and Xtend. We illustrate the application of the proposed approach and the developed tool to develop a set of reusable security thread and requirement model libraries following the strike categories from Microsoft. Finally, in our future work, we plan to improve the tool support to cover more aspects like reuse issues or more automation. For instance, we seek to handle the storage and the selection of the reusable models and to add an automatic incorporation of the result of the analysis into the domain-specific language software architecture model. We also like to study the integration of our tool with other MDE tools. The objective is to show the process flow and the integration of the tools in the domain tool chain. We will seek new opportunity to apply the proposed approach to other trade models. And moreover, a primary and promising result in the two domains of thread references indicate some interferences between threads that we plan to investigate further in the near future. Thank you for listening to this talk.